see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself.
Virgin Valley Artists Association welcomes you to the Art Box, recorded in our beautiful Mesquite, Nevada, and sponsored by the Virgin Valley Artists Association. Our association has something for everyone of all ages. Come and get creative with us at 15 West Mesquite Boulevard, or find us online at mesquitefineartcenter.com or on Facebook as Mesquite Fine Art Center, also on Facebook, The Art Box.
Hi, Diane. How are you today?
I'm doing great, Linda. How are you?
I'm fantastic. And guess who we have today visiting with us? Doreen Kinkade. Doreen, tell me how you spell your last name and why you spell it that way.
K-I-N-K-A-D-E. That's John's folks came from Scotland, and that's where the name came from. And his famous cousin is Thomas Kinkade, the painter.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
And somehow all that art drifted down to your genetics, right? Because you're Artist of the Month.
I know. I can thank John for that. He encouraged me way back when we first got married to do things. I wouldn't have got up in front of anybody for nothing, and now I'm teaching classes. So.
And John Kinkade, your husband, not John Kinkade.
Thomas Kinkade
was the artist. That's right. Okay.
No, my husband has encouraged me from the get-go.
Well, I have a lot of your art in my home. You know
you.
That, right? It's beautiful.
Yes, I do too. I remember when I first came here, I wasn't even living in Mesquite, and I saw your baskets. I said, I must have this. So I bought them, and then I moved them to Seattle, and then when I moved from Seattle to here, I brought them back.
Oh, wow. Very
so,
cool.
Yeah. So I have a couple of your baskets. I just love them.
The baskets has become quite a thing for me. I had two people that were in the gallery, and they said, where's this Doreen Kinkade? And they said, well, she's right there. She just came in. So they came up, and she goes, hi. She said, we would like to make a basket. And I said, oh, okay. Well, my daughter's leaving Thursday. So I did them yesterday, and they really enjoyed it.
How nice.
Yeah.
And you're teaching basket weaving, right?
Yes, I love it.
And you also do pottery and fabrics?
Yes, and cards.
And cards.
Yeah. I like to do a variety of things. I like to be busy. I can't just sit and do nothing. At TV time, it kills me to just sit there like this.
Sure.
I'll find something to do.
So tell us what your display will look like.
I'll have a wall of hanging pottery and a couple art quilts. The table will have pottery and baskets and some cards.
I love your quilts. I just think that you pick the most inspiring colors for me.
Thank you.
So I'm looking forward to seeing your display.
I don't know if I could bring my quilts in. I've had them in before. Maybe I should do that.
I think
because I do have a ladder that you can put on the side and hang.
I think you should.
You think so?
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely. They're
yeah,
beautiful.
I enjoy doing them, but now I've kind of moved from them. I'm really, really enjoying the basket teaching. When you teach somebody, when they walk out with something that they didn't think they could do, it's so rewarding.
Oh, sure. Absolutely.
Yeah. I have five beginners. Well, they were beginners. And I said, okay, this is the last class unless you want to carry on. Oh, no, we want to come back. We want to make more baskets. I can't get rid of the students I already have to get more. And I'm already booked for a new beginning class.
You're a popular teacher.
Yeah, I guess.
She is.
doing baskets, so I enjoy that. Now, the guilds back in Iowa, they're hurting because people don't want to go to the retreats and things. And I told them that you need to find a local art group and present it and get teaching people to get them to come. Because I'm not having any problem. I'm having, too many. Anyhow.
When did you get started with all of your artwork?
When Iowa, I used to have Christmas boutiques at my house. John made wooden items. I painted and detailed them. I made fabric Santas and snowmen and stuff like that. And then when we moved to Iowa, he went to Saudi. And so I went and took a basket class, and I took wood carving. And I got, they're all men in the wood carving. They were very nice, but it was not my thing. But the basket, I was hooked right from the get-go. So that was in 71 when he went to Saudi.
And John, thank you for your service.
You're welcome. So, I enjoyed all of it, all 23 years of it. Yeah.
So John was in the service. Mm-hmm. And
he's always been in the National Guard when we were in Iowa.
Okay.
So we always had that. So I've always done something art-wise. I took some classes with Margaret. She lives in, she used to live here in Abramshi, and she moved to St. George. And so that kind of got me started on the art quilts. She was the one that got me going on that. And so that's when I dropped doing quilt quilts. And I like doing the scenic, the landscape. That's my favorite. Although I'm working on right now one with the geraniums. So I'm trying to venture off into that. I don't know if it'll be done in time. It's on the table, but I just, I'm just so busy doing other stuff.
And your landscapes are so beautiful.
Thank you. I really enjoy those. I want to make another landscape tote. I really.
Oh, that would be beautiful.
That sold real fast at the Christmas boutique.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah. And the other thing I want to make is a landscape, but make it a vase.
Yeah. That would be nice. So now, when did you get involved in pottery?
Well, when we lived in California, there was an adult education. Mm-hmm. And so John and I went. He was on the wheel, and I did slab. We left there. Then that was the end of that. Then when we moved here, I came to the gallery. They had a little art show going outside, and there was Kathleen and Harlow. And they were having classes, and I thought, what the heck? That's something to do. So I signed up, and that was it. And it was just before the gallery was just opening.
Oh, wow.
Oh, so around 2003?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I thought. Mm-hmm. Okay. Wow, so you've been here a while.
The whole time.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And I love your wall pockets. Those are amazing.
That's my popular, and
yes,
I enjoy doing those. I'm having trouble, though. You can't get rust-colored eucalyptus.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. It's just, it's disappeared. I think it has something to do with China.
Oh, there's a lot of things you can't get anymore.
And the green just doesn't.
It doesn't look as nice.
Nope.
No.
No. So I got a little challenge there.
I have Doreen Kinkade wall pockets in my house. Doreen Kinkade baskets. Doreen Kinkade fabric creations and purses. She's quite an artist.
She is.
I enjoy it very much.
I
enjoy it.
Oh, we would love for you to... I don't know if you're interested, but boy, wouldn't it be great if you could do a class over at the pottery studio with wall pockets?
I don't know.
Something to think about.
I
know a lot of people ask me about them.
And do they?
Yeah, they always want to know.
I hadn't thought about that. I've got Mondays booked with...
Yeah, I know. You're so busy.
Basket classes.
We could maybe figure something out if you're
interested. Just a workshop, a one time.
Just a one time.
Yeah, one time.
That's probably enough. I know I've done classes before.
Yeah.
A lot of work. But
it is. But it's fun. It's fun to see somebody achieve something they didn't think so. They just think, I have no talent. You're wrong. Everybody has talent. You just got to bring it out.
That's what a good teacher does.
Everybody has talent.
Where did you meet this good-looking guy, John, sitting here?
I met him in California. He was a beach bum.
Uh-huh.
He lived at the beach. He had hair down here, and it was blonde.
Uh-huh.
And he worked at the gas station, and I was a bookkeeper. So it was the bookkeeper and the gas guy, the gas station guy.
He was going to college.
Yeah, he was going to college and working at the gas station.
And he was a surfer?
Oh,
yep.
And a bodybuilder?
Not really. I worked out, but it wasn't a bodybuilder.
But he was a surfer. He lived at the beach.
My husband tells me there's a picture that he's seen of John holding his arms up, and you're just hanging off of one of his arms.
Yeah, that was years ago.
In your bikini.
No.
Yeah. He loves that picture.
It had been 60 years ago or something. Bikinis are... <mm-mm. laughs> Is that the part you edit out?
I
have to tell you, Steve.
The part about me.
Steve edits.
Actually,
he doesn't
John's
edit
gonna
send anything.
Me the picture.
Oh.
So we'll put that up there. You'll be surprised. What, John?
Let me tell you a secret. Steve tells everybody he's going to edit things out, and I always ask him, I'll say, Steve, edit that. I didn't mean to say that. And then I listen to the podcast, and it's all in.
If it's interesting, it's staying in.
If it's interesting.
Okay, get me out of this. I'm trying to sell boring stuff.
We are, but I wanted to get into your background a little bit, too. So you liked art from the time you were little?
Yeah. When I was in kindergarten, I had I taught the kids how to put color up, crayons on their fingernails, and then we made little wings out of crepe paper, and we did some little play.
Yeah.
Oh, and then mostly I got it in California for that adult education. I took Batik, mm-hmm. pottery, copper enameling, and fabric collage. And here's what's hilarious. The board was here. The background fabric was here, and here's the stack of fabric. I could not pick up this piece and put it here. I could not. She says, well, just kind of set it around. I could not pick up these and put it here to design something. Then I made this thing. Finally, I cut out these kindergarten-looking flowers and stuck them on there. I tried to throw it in the trash. My son drug it out and kept it. But, I mean, I was that intimidated. Because she was just very artsy. She was my pottery teacher and that. And that's that. I credit her for starting the spark of the art side of the world because she opened so many doors for me.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah. And you've come so far from that as well.
Yeah, and with his encouragement.
Yes, true. True. I love what she does. And I took her out of being afraid to be herself, you know, and got her to doing stuff and crappy. We had sales all the time when we were in Iowa, you know. If it wasn't in the garage, it was raining in, we'd do it in the front yard or in the house.
In the house, we had the Christmas boutique in the house.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh,
and people, I had regular people would come every year to see what I had.
I have been in Iowa for a few China painting workshops years ago, and those Iowa women are really crafty and really artsy, and they have such good meals. The food was delicious.
Home-cooked meals,
yes.
They real food, you know, real food.
You got to remember that 6 months out of the year, you can't even get out of your damn garage sometimes.
That's true.
Yeah. You're by the time spring comes around, you're ready to let me out, you know.
I bet.
But that's the time you spend getting things made. And I don't know, I just have to be busy.
Well, and the gallery benefits and the organization, Virgin Valley Artists Association, benefits from Doreen being busy.
Yes. They make good money off of me.
They do.
Yeah.
And of all of your different talents and different parts of the art that you do, what is your favorite?
Right now it's the basket
weaving.
Yeah. Because when I started that as a Stay Smart with Art class. And I had some people, and then that was that. Then a couple of them said, well, can you teach some more? And I said, well, okay. So I started doing them. Well, I was a basic basket weaver because when we left Iowa, that's all I got to learn so far up to a certain level. So then now that I'm doing the classes, to give them a new technique, I had to go and learn a new technique on my own.
Wow.
No teacher, you know, and I don't like reading instructions either.
You and me both.
So that has made me grow because I'm teaching baskets that I had never made before. I'm teaching techniques that I have never done before. And so now my beginner class is kind of boring, so I took out a bunch of them because I just want to move them on to a prettier, better looking basket than
fabulous.
Basic, you know. But so I've grown tremendously from teaching because I have to have some new stuff because they won't quit. The first Monday class is my advanced, and there's five of them, or four of them right now. And I said, okay, are you guys done? Nope. We'll see you in the fall. Because I'm just ending them now all in April is the last for until fall. So I got to come up with new baskets, so then I have to make it first before I can teach it to them. So So I'm growing at the same time that they're growing.
What a nice compliment for you that they want to continue on in your classes.
Because I figure, well, two guys ready to stop? Nope. I want to make more.
So your display goes up in May?
May.
I can hardly wait to come in and look to see what else I need to add to my home collection.
Oh, dear. I'll have several baskets this time, where before I maybe had one, but I have a black and rust. They wanted to make a black and rust one, so I have that. I can't keep the basket. He put a shelf up in my room because I thought I'll put the samples up there. Mm-hmm. Well, I can't. I need to sell them because I have no room to keep a sample of every basket I teach. So here's a picture.
Oh, there you go.
That's okay.
Because I can't, you know. And I don't know what they're doing with them. Gail, she must have 20 baskets. And all the other ones in the Monday class, I don't know what they're doing with them, but
they're beautiful.
They don't want to stop.
So. And what I love about them is that you can store things in them.
Mm-hmm.
And I love art, you know, but it's a piece of art, and I can use it to in my kitchen or wherever. And
some
I
of them you should
that.
Use. If you, you should use them.
Oh, I do. Every one of them. But, I mean, it's kind of fun that this is art, and I'm using it to store my soaps or whatever. You know, it's like it's fun.
One of the last classes we did was a shopping cart. And I said, so it's a basket that you could put in that little kitty part for the thing to put like your vegetables so that they won't smash them when you check out. So I said, well, we all ought to show up at Smith's on the same day with these, and everybody have this basket. You know, we haven't done it, but
Smith's may be wanting to enlist your services.
And then you might be getting some more students.
I don't need any. I don't need any. I don't know when I'm going to teach them. There's only 4 Mondays.
I know. It's hard because I would love to take a class, but they're usually full.
Yeah. Well, like right now.
Yeah.
I have 6 people signed up for beginner class. I went, oop.
Doreen, thank you for being with us today. John, thank you for coming as well.
Thank you.
You're more than welcome.
And thank you for letting me be part of this podcast. That was fun. Thanks, Linda and Steve.
It was fun.
You. You did good.
Oh, thank you. Ooh, I was a little nervous. And we got through it.
Broadcasting from Mesquite, Nevada, in the scenic Mojave Desert, the Art Box sponsors thank you for listening. To find our next and past podcasts, find us online at mesquitefineartcenter.com, where all accompanying images and links are available on the Art Box page. Questions, comments, opinions, and concerns can be sent to artboxvv@gmail.com. The views and opinions expressed in this podcast are solely those of its hosts and guests and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the Virgin Valley Artists Association.